Welcome to online classes DU Nalgunda. My name is Sheikh Ibrahim, School Assistant Social Studies, ZPHS Gattupal. Today we are going to see about the 21st lesson of our textbook of 10th class, The Movement for the Formation of Telangana. The Movement for the Formation of Telangana, isn't it? You all know Telangana is the result of thousands of lives sacrification and 6 decades of long struggle for the independent state of Telangana. And finally, Telangana was formed on 2nd June 2014 as the 29th state in the Union of India. Undoubtedly, the achievement of Telangana state is a great thing that happened in a decent democratic way in the history of independent India, isn't it? So, Telangana was formed 2nd June 2014 as a 29th state in our country, isn't it? And why the people of Telangana demanding for separate state from 6 decades? There are certain reasons behind this demand. There are so many hesitations taking place for separate state, and finally they get succeed in 2014, isn't it? Now let us see how the Telangana state has been formed in 2014, isn't it? And first one is reasons for separate state. What are the reasons? There are so many reasons behind this demand, isn't it? And one by one, severe discrimination. There is a severe discrimination taken place in many fields from the ancient period. Culture, in terms of culture, tradition, language, identity as well, and political dominance by the Andhra state, and suppression of Nizams during the Nizams, okay. And one more thing is deliberate neglect of funds of Telangana by the rulers in different times. So, and main tagline of our Telangana movement, Telangana demand, is water, funds and employment. Water, funds and employment. Neelu, nidulu, niyamakalu, isn't it? So in this way, under this banner, the people of Telangana, they agitate for 6 decades, isn't it? And finally they get succeed. And one more thing is, next, the merger of Hyderabad state in the Indian Union in 1948, September 13th to 14th, there is a military operation taken place in Hyderabad state. India, we all know, India was ruled by the British people nearly 350 years. And finally, they got succeed and get independence from the British on August 15, 1947. By that time, when last Governor General of British, Lord Mountbatten, drafted a plan of Indian independence in 1947 June, the subcontinent of India has been divided into 3 domains. First one is India, second one is Pakistan, third one is princely states. When we got independence in 1947, August 15, India has nearly 562 princely states. 562 princely state. At the same time, Lord Mountbatten has given the freedom to the princely state rulers into three options. If you want to join with India, yes, you can merge with them. If you want to join with Pakistan, yes, you can merge with Pakistan. And third one is you may be remain independent. So in this way, when we got independence in 1947, nearly 559 princely states, they declared their princely states to merge into India, and only 3 princely states they did not join, either in Pakistan or India. They want to remain independent, that is Junagadh, Jammu and Kashmir, third one is Hyderabad princely state. After some long discussions and plebiscite taken place in Junagadh, the people of Junagadh want to merge with India. So in this way Junagadh has been amalgamated in India, whereas only 2 princely states left, that is Jammu and Kashmir, Raja Hari Singh, and the Nizam, that is Hyderabad state, Mir Usman Ali Khan was the 7th Nizam of Hyderabad princely state. But anyhow, at that moment, the first deputy prime minister of our independent India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, make some discussions with Hyderabad Nizam for merging the Hyderabad into Indian Union, but Nizam did not agree that demand, that request. And finally, the Indian Army decided to occupy by military action under the captaincy of Jayantnath Chowdhury, Jain Chowdhury. That operation, that means Operation Polo, that military action name was Operation Polo, which is taken place, which was taken place on 1948, September 13th to 17th. On September 17th, Hyderabad Nizam agreed his defeat and finally he merged with Indian Union. So in this way, Hyderabad state has been merged with Indian Union on September 17th, isn't it? Actually, Hyderabad is a combination of 3 regions. That is, first one is Telangana region, now what we are living, and Marathwada region, and third one is Kannada region. Telangana state, present Telangana state, which is ruled by the Nizam in 1940s and on even before. Total there are 16 districts in Hyderabad state. The 16 districts has been divided into 3 regions. Telangana region had 8 districts and Marathwada region has 5 districts and Kannada region has 3 districts. In this way, the princely state of Hyderabad having about 16 districts. So in this way, after the military operation, the Hyderabad state, that means the even Telangana also merged with Indian Union, from princely state to Indian Union, by giving some privileges to Nizam, like privy purse, title, dignity, and all these things. And finally, Nizam merged the Hyderabad state into Indian Union. In this way, the Hyderabad state has been annexed with India. And once the Hyderabad state merged with Indian Union, there are certain changes taking place during the course of time, isn't it? First one, military rule imposed after the Operation Polo, and military rule continued from 1948 September 17th to 1949 December 1st under Jayantnath Chowdhury's control. Later, the civil government 1949 December 1st to 1952 March 6th under the M.K. Vellodi is a civil officer. Later, the democratic government has been formed by the Burgula Ramakrishna Rao, was the first chief minister of Hyderabad state from 1952 to March 6th to 1956 November 1st. So, in this way, Hyderabad state was ruled by different stages. And during the course of time, the India got independence in 1947. After that, in 1950s and 1940s to 1950s, there is a agitations throughout India, some states demanding separate linguistic states, and based on linguistic demands. So, in this way, the Indian government formed many commissions and committees to pursue the issue of linguistic states demand, like S.K. Thor Committee 1948, J.V.P. Committee 1949, and Madras Division Committee by Kumaraswamy. Later, in the year of 1953, December 29th, the Fazal Ali Committee has been formed by the Indian government. It is popularly known as SRC, State Reorganization Commission. The SRC has given the report on September 30th, 1955. Based on the report, the AP state has been formed during these periods. And even before, in 1953, October 1st, based on the linguistic demands and committees reports, the Andhra state was formed, Kurnool as their capital city. Before formation of Andhra state, they are the part of Madras state. Andhra is combination of two regions, Rayalaseema as well as coastal Andhra. Madras state is ruled by the Britishers. When Andhra state was formed in the year of 1953, they had some scarcity in terms of infrastructure, financial deficit, and so many issues. That is why they want to merge Hyderabad state into Andhra state. And they made some discussions with the leaders of Hyderabad state. So, in this process, there is a great discussions taken place. After that, there is an agreement taken place between both leaders. That is, that agreement is known as Gentlemen's Agreement in the year of 1956, March 20th. In this agreement, it is a landmarked agreement for the formation of Andhra Pradesh. So, in the agreement, there are eight members signed, four from each region, from Andhra, Bijawada Gopal Reddy, Neelam Sanjeev Reddy, Alluri Satyanarayan Raju, Gautu Lachanna. In the same way, from Hyderabad state, there are four members or four leaders taking place and signed on gentleman agreement. They are namely Burgula Ramakrishna Rao, Marri Channareddy, Konda Venkat Rangareddy, and J.V. Narasingha Rao. So, in this way, there are 8 members signed a gentlemen's agreement in the year of 1956, February 20th. So, how many concepts they made deal? They made some agreement on different concepts. There are totally 14 concepts, like formation of TRC, Telangana Regional Committee or Council, and political reservation 60:40, and surplus funds of Telangana should be allocated to only Telangana region development, and certain water sharing agreements. So, in this way, there are 14 concepts agreed by the both leaders. So, in this way, the gentlemen's agreement had its a significant event while merging the Hyderabad state into Andhra state. So, in this way, when Andhra state agreed for the 14 concepts, the Telangana leaders ready to, that means Hyderabad state leaders, they agreed to merge Hyderabad state into Andhra state. In this way, on November 1st, 1956, the Andhra Pradesh state has been formed. Hyderabad as their capital city. When Hyderabad state merged with Andhra state, the total problems and infrastructure scarcity, administrative buildings and capital city problem all solved with this agreement only. Okay, isn't it? When the people of Hyderabad ready to merge with Andhra and formed as a Andhra Pradesh, at that moment our first Prime Minister of independent India has given a statement in the year of 1956, before merging the Hyderabad state into Andhra, isn't it? Because Telangana people, innocent, hard working nature and a honesty attitude, but whereas Andhra people, they are the ruled by the British before independence. So, they had some sort of attitudinal difference from Andhra to Telangana. They had some commercial attitude, cunning and decisive nature. That is why Jawaharlal Nehru has given the statement when Hyderabad state merged into Andhra and formed as a Andhra Pradesh. He has given the statement in Nizamabad public meeting in Khalilwadi grounds. He described Andhra as a cunning and decisive boy, and described Telangana as an innocent girl, that we are going to marry between Andhra boy and Telangana girl. That means merging of Hyderabad state into Andhra for formation of Andhra Pradesh. He has given the statement. I would like to quote his own words. A masoom Telangana ko ek natkati Andhra ke saath joda ja raha hai. Hum chahte hai ki a milap sayog rahega. Agar nahi raha, jab chahe tab, a Telangana apne Andhra ke saath talaak lekar a sakti hai. That means that a word come true in the year of 2014, June 2nd. That means he has given the divorce to the Andhra, and finally they achieved as an independent state in the Indian Union, isn't it? So, in this way, there are certain discussions taken place before formation of Andhra Pradesh, and finally our Telangana state people and leaders agreed for this, isn't it? And Andhra Pradesh has been formed. After certain changes, they got bitter experience after the formation of Andhra Pradesh. The Telangana people again decided to form as a separate statehood. They made so many hesitations later. Okay, we will discuss the rest of the lesson in next video. Thank you. Welcome to online classes DU Nalgunda. My name is Sheikh Ibrahim, School Assistant Social Studies, ZPHS Gattupal. Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss the rest of the part of the previous video. 1969 agitation of Telangana. You all know, in the year of 1956, February 20th, there is an agreement taken place between both regions or both states, that is Hyderabad state as well as Andhra state, for formation of Andhra Pradesh. In that agreement, there are many privileges and promises given by the Andhra leaders for merging of Hyderabad state into Andhra. Later, the people of Telangana witnessed many violations which are given by the Andhra leaders during the time of gentleman agreement. And they did not satisfied with their promises, their actions, and finally they made one more agitation in the year of 1969, Telangana agitation. And why the people of Telangana made one more agitation for separate statehood is, behind that movement there are certain reasons is there. After the formation of Andhra Pradesh, the Telangana was neglected by the Andhras. They dishonor the identity of Telangana region, and the discrimination in many fields like this. So let us discuss about the reasons behind the 1969 Telangana agitation. One by one. Number one, the violation of the gentleman agreement promises. The very first day of the formation of Telangana witnessed the beginning of the violations of promises, which was chart out in gentleman agreement. You all know, if you go through the gentleman agreement, there are certain concepts. If the person or candidate or representative selected from Andhra, then he became a CM. If CM should from Andhra, the deputy CM from Telangana region. And sharing of ministries in assemblies, and there is a ratio 60 Andhras and 40 ministries from Telangana. So in this way, and one more thing is, the surplus funds of Telangana should be only spent for development of Telangana only. And water sharing. So in this way, there are many points agreed by the both leaders during the time of gentlemen agreement, isn't it? And injustice in employment, there are certain injustice taking place by the Andhra rulers while giving the employment to Telangana people. They made so many injustices in terms of reservation, local non-local quota. They misused the GOs and they manipulate according to their convenience. They lobbying in various fields to divert the employment to non-Telangana people, and misuse of funds. You all know, we already discussed the funds sharing about the Telangana during the time of gentleman agreement. The surplus funds should be allocate for the development of Telangana only, but it is not done in the fields. In actual ground, the funds has been misused by the Andhra rulers. That is why the people of Telangana, they became dissatisfied with the funds misuse. And deliberate neglect in development of Telangana by the Andhra rulers. They deliberately neglected the development of Telangana in various fields, in terms of education, in terms of water sharing, projects, universities, healthcare, infrastructure, and employment. In many fields, there is a deliberate neglect taken place by the Andhra rulers after the formation of Andhra Pradesh. That is why the 1969 Telangana agitation taken place. After long observation, that means nearly 12 years or 13 years after the merging of Telangana into Andhra, they want to start one more agitation in the name of 1969 Telangana agitation and reduce the powers of TRC. TRC means Telangana Regional Council, which is promised by the Andhra leaders in during the gentleman agreement. But the powers of Telangana Regional Commission has been reduced by the Andhra rulers, deliberately reduce the status of regional council to regional committee, which had no any powers to develop Telangana. That means the authority of the Telangana Regional Council to committee status, that is why the powers of Telangana Regional Council has been reduced, isn't it? And divert water sharing funds to their regions. Divert water sharing funds to their regions. That means water sharing also, there is a injustice taking place in water sharing and funds also, isn't it? And political dominance, there is a dominance taking place in political field, a political authority by the Andhras. The people of Telangana experienced a bitter experience in the hands of the Andhra rulers. That means they politically dominated by their behavior. They tried to suppress the Telangana leaders in many fields, and they lobbying with the central government. So in this way, the leaders of Telangana, that means the representatives of Telangana, also dissatisfied along with the Andhra rulers. That means in the combined Vishalandhra, that means in the combined state of Andhra Pradesh. So in this way, there are certain reasons before going to start the Telangana movement in the year of 1969, and aggressive attitude of the Andhra people. They had a aggressive towards the Telangana innocents, and dishonor the Telangana identity as well. They dishonor the Telangana identity even, which is a very very important for this movement. The people of Andhra, the leaders of Andhra, they dishonor the Telangana identity. They never allow the leaders of Telangana in the assembly to pronounce the word Telangana. Instead, they suggested the leaders of Telangana pronounce as a, utter as a, call as a backward state, not Telangana region. They never accept this word even in assembly also, Andhra Pradesh assembly also. Actually, Telangana is not a backward state. Telangana is not a backward region. It made it backward by the Andhra rulers. That is why the people of Telangana, they made severe agitation, severe movements against the Andhra rulers, against the Andhra dominance. So in this way, there are so many reasons taken place to start the 1969 Telangana agitations. Many people, many sections of the Telangana society take part in this movement, and students also take part very actively for the achieving of Telangana in 1969 agitation. During this course of time, by the suppression of the Andhra rulers, they used police force to suppress the movement. They arrested and put into jails without inquiry, and finally the agitation taken place. In this agitation, about 369 students sacrificed their life for the sake of Telangana as well. Isn't it? You remember one, it is very very important. Why the people of Telangana is dissatisfied by the Andhras. So in this way, the growing discontent, that mean discontent means dissatisfaction, is going on. That is why the people of Telangana made a severe agitation in the name of Idli Sambar Go Back, by certain slogans. Idli Sambar Go Back, Telangana Jago Andhra Bhago, because Telangana is a self-respect dignity region. The Andhra people ruled by the British under the British presidency. In the year of 1969, the people of Telangana has made a slogan about Idli Sambar Go Back, and finally they made a great movement. After that, there are certain changes taking place after this movement, and one more movement taken place in the year of 1990s, during the period of 1990s. Also, they made some protest against the rulers of Andhra, the administration of Andhra. And in this part, the tribal movements or tribal organizations or caste organizations has been formed, like Golla Kurma Dol Debba, वड्डेरा गन्नु देब्बा आदिवासी तुडुम देब्बा लंबाड़ा नगारा चाकली रेव देब्बा सो इन दिस वे देर आर सो मेनी कैस्ट ऑर्गनाइजेशंस वर्क फॉर तेलंगाना स्टेट अगेंस्ट द आंध्रास एंड वन मोर स्टेप्स taken by the intellectuals to make some awareness regarding the concept of Telangana. They published so many journals and pamphlets to create awareness among the people of Telangana society regarding the Telangana region. In the year of 1988 there is a one more organization has been set up by the Telangana intellectuals, that is Telangana Information Trust. They published many books and pamphlets. They get succeed to aware the people of Telangana society towards the Telangana goal, isn't it? And Telangana Janasabha and Telangana Mahasabha has been formed in the year of 1997 to focus the separate state for the fighting for justice of Telangana rights against the Andhra dominance. They create awareness among the people, the importance of Telangana, the importance of Telangana independent state. So in this way, they made so many public meetings to make awareness among the people. And finally, there are so many meetings also conducted by the many leaders and organizations like Karimnagar Nagara, Warangal Yuddaberi and Jagityal Jatara. So in this way, different taglines, they conducted some many public meetings to make public aware regarding the Telangana state, the independence of Telangana, the importance of Telangana as well. So finally, they get succeed to focus the Telangana issue into the public, the importance of independent state, the dominance of the political leaders, how they are dominating the Telangana people, Telangana leaders, how they are lobbying the central government against Telangana, how they are misusing the funds and water sharing, how they are making injustice towards our people in terms of culture, language, traditions, Telangana identity and employment also. That is why the Telangana movement has been started again in 1969 also and the 1990s also. Even after in 2000 onwards, there is a great movement taken place for achieving of Telangana state. So in this way, many incidents taken place before formation of our independent state in the Union of India. Telangana was formed finally based on these past agitations, and finally we get succeed to achieve our independent state of Telangana as a 29th state in the Union of India on 2nd June 2014. Okay, the rest of the lesson we will discuss in next video. Thank you.